Okay, folks, coming at you with something different here today. It's David Schneider, Whiskey City Traditional Archers. And we had our shoot, which was July the 9th, it was Sunday. And we had a great turnout. For a trad club, we're growing by leaps and bounds, and I can't be happier. We had 80-some shooters, and I'm really happy about that. But, you know, there's some things that we've done. We've had some sponsors step up to the plate. So for everybody that turns in a scorecard, they will be put in for a chance for a triple T string. Scott Riffner. Riffner? Did I say it right, Scott? I know Scott. I think Riffner. I think that's it. But anyway, he won it last shoot, and Trevor has signed on. Trevor is a member of Whiskey City Trad, and he has signed on to give a string away at all the remaining shoots. So our next shoot, scheduled for next month, we'll have another triple T string. But this is for the July 9th shoot, and I'm going to do something a little different. Triple T string. Let me grab these. Let's see. Also, it's like the most, I don't know what I'm screaming for. I have got a cordless lapel mic, so I don't have to scream anymore. That's why I lost my voice in the first place. But anyway, so we had roughly about 50 scorecards turned in, a little more. There they are. And we usually don't get but about 20% of our scorecards turned in. So I don't know if that's a triple T nudge or not, but we're definitely getting more scorecards turned in. So the only way you can be entered to win a chance at triple T string is to turn in your scorecard. So today I'm going to do a little bit something different, and I will take you over to determine the winner. I will take you over to the practice range here and tell you what I got in mind. All right, folks, there you have it. That was a little bit laborious. I'm a little bit winded. I got a little bit of a sweat going on here, a little bit of a lather, if you will. Got the sun beaming down on me here. And yeah, so I just want you all to know that I'm going through extreme measures here to bring you some entertainment. So here we go. All right, hold on just a second. Let me grab my thing here. Everything is still rolling as far as video goes. The bow that I chose to shoot this with is a backcountry longbow. It's a light one. It's like a 39 at 28. Looks like it's got a homemade string on it. Not sure of the maker. It's probably the Bowyer. And you can't get these bows anymore. This bow was made by Kenny Jordan. Kenny Jordan, he's club member, longbow shooter. Made bows for about a year and a half. Cranked out quite a few of them until he decided, for whatever reason, it wasn't for him. Or I don't know. So there's still kind of a few floating around in the area. So I went and snagged some up. This one's a Purple Heart, I believe. And I don't know, it's got some micarta maybe, some G10. I don't know what that is, to be honest with you. But anyway, yeah. So I'm gonna try this thing. I think I've shot it twice in my life. Still a few of them floating around here local. So I went and found who had them and snagged them up. I like Kenny and I like his bow. Gonna quit making them. I tell him all the time. He don't agree. But anyway, so here it is for all the marbles. And I don't know if you guys can see this. Look at the knocking points. I can't get that one to spin up to save my life. So look at the gap there that I have. So there's the first, I don't know what this bow, the fist meal or what the brace is, or look at that. It looks about dead level. So my knocking point's definitely not right. We're 30 yards down there. Now there's some gaps in there, so I could miss and have to shoot again, but I'm nervous about this bow. I'll try to pull something off here. 30 yards. For the triple T string, Whiskey City Traditional Archers. Lord knows I got a dang helicopter or something flying over right now. Oh, I got the cordless mic on. You might not even be able to hear that. Yeah, anyway, it's like a Chinook. Oh my gosh, it's flying low. I don't know if you guys can see that, super low. Check that out. Right over the trees. I don't know if y'all can see that. Yeah, well, that was a Blackhawk, I believe. I believe that was a Blackhawk. So I'm pretty sure what'll happen is some of you helicopter aficionados will get on here and say, oh, that wasn't a Blackhawk snide. That was a, you know, an H-23BW Vietnam era, something or another. I'm not a helicopter expert. I seen Blackhawk down. It looked like that dang thing that went down. I'm pulling an arrow, got one on the shelf. Okay, here we go, enough talking. A bow that I've shot maybe twice, never shot it at all this year. Knock points all off, and I'm standing on one leg. One leg, here we go. For the triple T string, that's gonna suck. Wow. Okay, one leg. That's gonna stink. Man, I don't have no balance. Let's go down and check it. I missed the card. I missed it. So we'll leave that one right there. We'll try it again. Didn't hit a card. I'm making an absolute idiot out of myself. I don't care. It's all for good fun. Whatever. If you're not having fun in this sport, why are you doing it? We'll do this one off a knee. I think I hit one that time. So I'm gonna go ahead. I definitely hit one. I hit my arm right there. Yeah. Yeah. You've gotta be kidding me. Did I miss? No, okay. It's hit a card. There is definitely a card hit there, folks. My camera's gonna fall over. I'm no Steven Spielberg by no means, but anyway. So it has hit a card right here. We will see who that is for the triple T string. I'm gonna pull it. Ooh, I'm not even gonna look. I'm gonna turn it to the camera. I don't know if y'all can see that or not. How about this camera? Either camera. All right, let's see who it is. It is, oh my gosh. I knocked out the name. Olivia's. Oh, I don't know which Olivia's brother this is. There's two of them. Shot a 217. Shot a 217. And I think these are the boys that came with Scotty Dorton. So anyway, yeah, longbow class, Olivia's. I think that's him. So anyway, 217, that was your score. We shot your scorecard. You, my friend, have got you arguably the best string in the business. I'm a little biased, folks. I don't care. You know, I don't
want to ruffle up the daggone
string builders community. I'm probably going to get a bunch of heat for saying this, but I just died in your arms tonight. There must have been something you said. I just died in your arms tonight. I keep looking for something I can't get. Broken hearts lie all around me, and I don't see an easy way to get out of
here. 1 hour later.
Oh, anyway, appreciate it. I can't remember your first name, daggone it. Olivia's, you won a triple T string, and congratulations. That's all I got. I'm ruining the whole video by running my giblets. All right, guys, see ya.